will be watching the video while I'm making it.
Really, Brutus? You're gonna attack my son?
One cup of peanut butter, 2 tablespoons of honey, 1 egg, and 1 teaspoon of baking powder.
Really? Did it break?
Yeah, it did.
What? Well, no, not that. I'm talking about this. I don't care about the ring. Goddamn video with me. Yeah, which are 1 cup. Not my date today.
Who is it?
Down there. You can cross it out. And then 1/4 cup, which just put it all like this, just in case you need it. And this one, which is 1/3 cup. So, yeah. And then, yeah, we have the mixable and everything, so, yeah.
Cone-shaped cookie cutter and a fork. The first thing that we're going to do is we're going to combine our flour, egg, and baking powder.
Like I said, we don't have an egg, so we're going to try our best.
Thank you.
means I'm doing it very high. I should just put it over there. No, I'm actually just gonna put it over here. Let me just move this. Okay. And we're taking our mixture, and mixing it. A little bit more honey, just to give it a little bit.
Into the mixing bowl. Then we're just gonna give it a quick mix. Next, we are gonna add our water.
So the water.
Peanut butter and honey to the
peanut butter. How much peanut butter do we need? About 1 cup. Okay, so I'm actually just gonna take a cup at that time now. Can you see it, please? Thank you. I need a spoon, please. Try my best and just get it pretty good.
Mac and cheese.
Well, that's for you.
Yeah.
How about for me, you not?
By the way, I do make some killer mac and cheese.
Yeah.
You gotta admit, I do make
Zip
it.
As usual, nothing you can really do. You just try your best to scoop a lot of it.
Just warm it and tell me if it's done.
Longer, Ben.
Alright.
Don't forget, my mom don't have teeth.
What's that got to do with it?
It's still a little bit hard. Hard.
Watch those potatoes. I was just gonna do is fork them to see if they're done. Once they're done, pour out the hot water and pour the cold water on them. Alright. I don't want a mess in here, dude.
Yes, Mom. Don't forget, you're on video. Ow! That's what I get for not telling her before she comes in.
Oh, it's a gun wet.
Maybe I should start doing videos more often. Maybe she'll watch her mouth more often. Love you, Mommy. They still see you.
Come on.
Fucking
hungry.
Ma! Watch your mouth.
Shut that thing off.
What, this?
Oh.
What?
What she's doing over there.
No! My YouTube channel.
You're supposed to be doing your science.
Yeah, but you know what? My cats.
Nothing.
My animals are more important.
Yeah, like.
Oh, sorry.
No cat no more.
Where's the honey? Oh, it's back over there. Yes. It says 2 tablespoons, but I'm just gonna put 1/4. So just maybe it'll help give it more of a.
I'll go using all my honey
dot. I won't. I'm only using that much. Not that much.
What did you do to my ball? Oh, I thought it was a hole in that. It's a shiny. Look from here, it looks like there's a hole in it. It's a shiny cleaver. Oh!
What?
Come here!
Oh, there
you go. Mom told you you put a hole in her ball. You're staying right here. It looks like you put a hole in it like that, but it's the cleaver.
Oh, wow, Ma.
No. Just no, Sarah, leave that. Come look.
What's that?
Stand like right where I'm standing if you look at it.
Ha! That's awesome. So you did the honey and the peanut butter and the flour. So yeah, we're all set.
Oh. Then you're gonna mix together until everything is well combined. And then this would make it more of a dough.
Yeah, that's
fine.
She wanted me to add the cheese.
Well, yeah, you add cheese right after me, huh?
Ready, and it's ready to roll out. And a really good thing to know about.
Can you put that thing back on, please? I'm already sweating like crazy. It's so hot.
About this recipe is that it's not going to rise very much because we've only added one egg. So when you're rolling it out, you'll want to roll it to the thickness that it will be at the end. I like to shoot for about a half an inch. So you're just going to take a little flour, sprinkle it over your surface.
So like she said.
Work because
we is supposed to prevent the stuff from sticking to your hand, but it's not. Put some in my hand, please. Yeah, that's good. Not a lot.
That's what bakers do, they take the flour and put it in their hands.
I'm just gonna try to dump it over. Next time I'll make sure I have an egg.
Think about it.
Take them down. Yeah, there. So what I am gonna do is I'm gonna give up. I'm gonna try to scrape as most of this stuff off as I can. I'm gonna get up. And I am gonna go and wash the access off.
Really?
And have cleaner hands and wet stick here. Just to try to see if maybe
yeah.
Because my
yeah.
hands are too sticky.
Maybe?
I'm about the dog specifically. Just, you know, like I said, I'm gonna need it. There.
Huh?
It says, go there. Still got everything all over me. So what I am gonna do is grab it. Take whatever is left that's not here. Scrape it. Thank you. I don't know how to do that. She, what did she say?
Hold it and see if it's fine.
Stop?
Yeah.
Then don't do it until it turns off.
There.
No. You know what you can do though?
What?
Wash the things because I'm gonna need them for the next video for the chicken. The ice chicken. Yeah, I'm just gonna redo it, see what I can. dog. Make them a little bigger for my dog Diamond. Small ones. I'll just pull it by my fingers and just do it. I'm not too big. Trying to take care of my animals, you know. Trying to do a little rabbit here. What?
The
Bobby chains?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Doesn't stick. Then you're gonna take your dough, press it down. Oh, it smells so good. It smells like peanut butter. Then we're just gonna roll it out about half an inch thick. Now you're gonna take your bone-shaped cookie cutter. This is so cute. And we're just gonna cut out a bunch of our little peanut butter biscuits. Now you're gonna remove the excess dough around your cookies and transfer them to your baking sheet. This part is totally optional, but I like to add a little detail to our dog biscuits. Cookie won't know the difference, but I think it's really fun. Kind of like when you make peanut butter cookies, you press the fork in different angles and it has that signature peanut butter cookie look. I like to make signature biscuit look by taking a fork and then just pressing straight down to make little divots. Now we're gonna bake these in the oven at 350 degrees for about 18 minutes. Just keep your eye on them.
Oh, 350 degrees?
350.
And then just pressing straight down to make little divots. Now we're gonna bake these in the oven at 350 degrees for about
350 degrees.
Okay.
It's all done first. Okay. Now.
Oh, this little right here.
The middle.
Okay.
So what I'm gonna do with the access. And yeah, like she said, 350 degrees and then wait 18 minutes to see if it cooks. But for the access, I'm going to take, can you go give me the wax paper, please? It looks like tape. So what I'm going to do is take some wax paper, lay it out like that. Now, I was... Ron didn't tell me this, but, I did it before, and then finding out I did it the right way, though, before I had, like, every ingredient is what she said, how she said it. And then a few weeks after it turned moldy, so that's pretty weird, so just watch out for that. You know, that'd be really good. So, bye guys! I'll see you later!